Hey guys, it's Greg. How's it going? Today we're going to talk about how to get out of a slump. And if you don't know that particular word, slump, well, it essentially means, hey, maybe a day, maybe a week, maybe for a month, you've just been not really feeling it. You know, it doesn't necessarily mean, you know, I'm not going to use the super dark words, although you probably guess what I'm referring to. It doesn't necessarily mean something that dark, but it at least means, hey, I'm not trying super hard. I don't care that much. I at least can't get myself to be super productive today. And, you know, I think we've all been there, to be honest. Like, I can think of many times in my life, you know, recent as well as way past, you know, several times throughout my life that, you know, I just haven't really been able to get myself to do what I, you know, really wanted to do. Or maybe there wasn't anything in particular that I really did want to strive for. And I think that's the big piece already is, you know, you need something to strive for. It's okay to have a slump day where, you know, you have a particular goal in mind, but today, you know, you can't get yourself to work towards that goal. That's okay. It might just be burnout. Like maybe you've done so much of the same thing for so long that, you know, you can't really do it today. That's fine. Take a break day. That's all right. You know, if it is your full-time job and you feel like you're slumping at your job, well, maybe you need a switch of job. Maybe you need to just take it easy that day. Maybe you need to fully take that day off and come back stronger than ever. Whatever it is, it's okay if you are in a slump. But no matter what it is, you do need some sort of long-term goal that you're constantly striving for. And for me, you know, I think it's relatively obvious at this point, but just to go out right and say it, like, I want this channel to be as successful as possible. YouTube, LinkedIn, I've kind of given up on Twitter, to be honest, but maybe I'll go back to Twitter at some point. But it doesn't matter. I want that to be as successful as possible. And, you know, your goal doesn't have to be anything similar to that as in the slightest. And that's also not necessarily my only goal. You know, that's one of the things I think about consistently. But you're totally allowed to have multiple goals in mind and either, you know, maybe put aside some of them for now and then really work towards one of them. Or maybe all at once, you're kind of simultaneously all working towards each of those individual goals. Whether it's one or multiple goals, you know, you gotta have something to wake up for, to go to sleep and just, you know, you don't want to be stuck not sleeping because you're so concerned about it. But I really do suggest, you know, you have something where you're going to sleep thinking like, hey, if I wake up in the morning, like maybe I can do this. Or, you know, maybe if I just keep doing the same thing for long enough, you know, something good is going to happen. And, you know, for a lot of you, at least for, you know, my subscribers, I'm sure that that is, you know, trying to be, you know, a data scientist or a data analyst. And of course, you know, you've probably seen it by now, but I do have the pathway to become a data scientist and an analyst in the description of the video. So if that's what you're looking for, then, you know, I would recommend taking a look at that and, you know, taking your time on it. Someone actually pointed out today, they're like, hey, this is potentially years of work. And hopefully it's not that long. Hopefully you kind of exponentially ramp up the speed at which you start doing things because, you know, you can probably start learning the later material a lot faster than the beginning stuff because, you know, the really beginning stuff, like you might breeze through it. But then once it starts to be a little bit difficult, you'll be pushing yourself through the material and you'll become a better and better learner over time. So I'm sure many of you, that goal is to try kind of go through and become a data scientist or analyst. And I hope I've done everything I can possibly do towards that. But, you know, for anyone listening, including those subscribers and maybe people that are clicking on this for the first time, you know, how do you get out of a slump? Well, of course, you need some long term goal to think about. But, you know, sometimes, you know, many people and I've found myself in this a few times as well. Is, you know, like you might still be in a slump, even though you have some long-term goal to think about. You're like, hey, I really want to get to this. But then you still have like some week where it's like, man, I just, you know, I can't really, you know, I can't really work on this today. And again, breaks are fine. Burnout is okay. Like you'll get back to it eventually. But, you know, sometimes, and I've definitely seen this with people, and it's totally okay as well, but you want to get out of this slump if you're really stuck in it. Like, you know, if you've gone on for like a week or so now, and you're kind of stuck in this same swamp, how do you get out? Well, there is many things that you could do. You could, of course, continue to break and basically bore yourself with boredom. I like that phrase. I don't know if that's been used before, but bore yourself with boredom, which is essentially, you know, if you're wasting your time. If you're enjoying your time, that's great. But if in your mind you're kind of wasting time, say playing video games or, you know, just kind of being outside and not really doing anything interesting, or for many of you probably sitting there scrolling on social media, that's okay as well. That's pretty common nowadays. But if that is the case, then you could essentially bore yourself with boredom, where you keep doing those things for long enough for, you know, days until you're literally like, hey, I need to come back to something interesting. Like, I need my brain to be more active than it is right now. And I want to be solving problems. I want to be working towards this goal. And eventually you might get so bored out of this that you can't, you have to go back, basically. So that's one way to do it. And I've done that, and I've seen other people do that. But, you know, sometimes that doesn't work as well. Like, sometimes that might just get you, say, further and further into the swamp. And so if that really doesn't work, if that doesn't seem to be working, then something I would recommend doing is just go like half work, basically. So if you are like trying to learn about something or trying to make a project or whatever it may be, just, you know, on a different tab of your computer or on your phone or whatever, just open something. Open up a machine learning tutorial video. Open up a blog. Open up someone's project that they've done, or, you know, anything. I'm talking back in the data science realm, as for many of you, but whatever it may be, open up some learning material and just continue to keep doing what you were doing, like social media or whatever. But occasionally kind of look over, kind of listen to what they're trying to say. And that will basically force your brain to pay some attention to this other material. And I don't suspect that you'll learn an absolute ton out of doing this. Like, to be honest, you're probably not going to absorb either material very well. Humans aren't amazing at multitasking in general. You know, sometimes we can do multiple things, but you can't really do multiple things super well most of the time. And yeah, so have that like open on a different tab, and then just keep doing what you're doing. And little by little, you'll absorb a little bit of the information. And most importantly, you'll kind of keep reminding yourself that, like, hey, this is something you care about. This is, you know, if you paid full attention to this, then you really would understand this. And maybe maybe that doesn't fix it at this particular time. Like, if you literally start doing that, maybe that doesn't immediately fix your slump. But maybe the next day you'll be like, hey, I remember that they were talking about this material, and I wish I understood that better, and I wish I could follow that. And then, so before you start your day with 2 hours of slump or whatever it may be, you know, maybe have breakfast and still kind of, you know, get hydrated and that type of thing. But before you initiate those social media type activities, maybe just go on to fully dedicate yourself to watching the material or doing your own material, like working towards your own coding project or whatever it may be. And so that's one way. It basically, you know, slowly shifted your brain over to away from the slump and back towards the original material. And then, of course, if that doesn't work as well, if you just are really not paying attention, you can't get yourself to care about those things, well, you have to hit some point where you just say, like, hey, like, enough is enough. Like, you can stare at yourself in the mirror, or, you know, I have a camera, so stare at myself in the camera. I can't actually see myself right now, but I know that it's pointing back at me. Whatever. Why did I talk about that? I have no idea. Basically, you can stare yourself in the mirror and then be like, hey, enough is enough. You are about to go do this right now. You know, whether it's for 20 minutes, for an hour, you know, you can't force yourself to do things for long periods of time. Just, you know, it's very, very difficult to do that. But for a short period of time, you can definitely go and say, hey, I need this to be done, or I really want this to be done. I am forcing myself to do this. And what that at least did is brought you out of the slump for 20 to 30 minutes, but almost certainly it would wake you up and push you back towards that realm of working hard and consistently towards your goal. And as long as in general you have that long-term goal and you know you are doing things actively or at least you know the active things that it takes to push yourself towards that goal, you'll probably naturally go back to them. And so hopefully, you know, most of these techniques aren't even necessary. Hopefully you just take a break and then get back to it. But those are some of the ideas. Those are the ways in which I and maybe other people I've seen can kind of shift yourself back to that hardworking state. So I hope that helped. And if you're not subscribed to the channel, you know, maybe consider doing so. You can always change your mind if you don't want to. And for the rest of you that are already subscribed and know me well, thank you so much for watching. I really hope this does help. And please consider, checking out those links in the description to go see the data science roadmap and data analyst roadmap if you have not seen those already. I'm guessing you have, but if you haven't, take a look at that. And yeah, have a great day, guys. Have a great evening. It's Canada Day over here, July 1st, and I think fireworks may happen, but the weather's not looking fantastic. It's looking like it might thunderstorm. So hopefully they push those off to another day. I just realized that my hat had this kind of dirty thing on it, and that's not something I'm a fan of. Anyways, have a great day, guys. I'll see you later. Bye-bye.